Somebody there, praise the Lord.
Okay, hallelujah.
If you're expecting manifestation tonight,
to ban reti farahan Olorun lale,
demonstration tonight,
if you saw you shall agbara Olorun lale,
deliverance tonight,
idande lale yi,
power tonight,
agbara nla lale yi,
and the rolling away of your problem,
yiyi awon isoro re kuro lasale yi.
Somebody there, praise the Lord.
Eni kan nibe, ke hallelujah.
There's no name like the name of Jesus.
Osoruko kan to dabi oruko Jesus.
There's no power like the power of Jesus.
Osi agbara kan to dabi agbara Jesus.
No salvation in your other place. No deliverance in your other place. Everything is found in that name. And it's coming to you tonight. Are you there?
So
are you waiting?
So
are you expecting?
So
it will come upon your life in Jesus' name. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this glorious day. A day of manifestation. Manifestation of your power. In these days in which we live, like the olden time, we pray you open the windows of heaven. And you pour your blessings now upon your people. And we're asking tonight, you will turn every life around. Roll every mountain away. Destroy the works of the devil. Set your people free. Let it be manifestation tonight. Manifestation tonight. Manifestation everywhere. And your people will be glad in you. We thank you because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless everyone. Please, you can sit down. We're coming to one verse of the Bible. It's a verse that came out of the mouth of Jesus Christ. Actually, he was born miraculously. He lived miraculously. Maybe you have heard the story before he died on the cross. He died for a purpose. Because of you, so that life will come to you. I'm talking about active life. I'm talking about powerful life. I'm talking about eternal life. I'm talking about abundant life. I'm talking about a kind of life, heavenly life, that comes to you tonight. Tonight, manifestation in your life. What's the person I'm talking to there? It will come upon your life in Jesus' name. And as Jesus Christ came, after he rose from the dead, these words came out of his mouth. And he comes to give you the word today. He's the one who died. He's the one who rose from the dead. The one that has all power, all authority. Angels bow before him. And men worship him. And when you give your life to that Lord, and you recognize him, and you believe him, and you surrender to him, there will be manifestation in your life. There will be demonstration of his glory in your life. Matthew chapter 28. And I'm reading from verse 18. Matthew chapter 28, verse 18. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. And Jesus came after his resurrection. After the stone was rolled away, the power of God came from heaven. And then he rose again. All those guards fell on the ground. And then he rose triumphantly. Death is conquered. The devil is conquered. Sin is conquered. All your problems are conquered. And now he came to his disciples. And he came to announce to them. And Jesus came unto them. And now Jesus comes unto you. Where you are there tonight, he comes before you. And he comes in your presence. He comes to announce unto you. And he spoke unto them. And now he's speaking to us. If you will recognize his voice, if you will accept his utterance, if you will believe his saying, the power in his words, the authority in his words will work in your life tonight. And it will be dynamic in your life tonight. He said unto them, like he's saying unto you today, he said, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. In heaven and in earth. As high as heaven is, his power is that high. As low as earth is, the power reaches everyone on earth. On the mountain, in the valley, in the village, in the city, in the church, on the field, anywhere and everywhere, the power of Christ we're talking about cannot be limited, cannot be restricted. That's why it says all power. Think about that. All power. Meditate on that. All power. Apply that to your ailment. All power. Apply that to your situation. All power. That's the same power with God. The power that the Almighty God has, he has. All power in heaven and on earth. The same divine ability belonging to the Almighty God. That same divine ability belongs to him. The power that can create. The power that can rescue your life. The power that can change your situation. The power that can roll your mountains away. All power. All power in heaven. Infinite power. Unlimited power, irresistible power. That demon in your life will not resist that power tonight. That mountain in your life will not resist that power tonight. That sickness tonight will go after we mention the name of Jesus. Because he has might, he has power, he has authority, he has ability. He has all power in heaven, all power on earth. And his power is over angels, over men, over women, over your problems, over that affliction, over that attack, over every evil. He restrains every evil thing. He stops every evil thing. It destroys every work of the devil. And it cleanses our sins. It changes our lives. And it comes tonight because he's still alive. Jesus Christ the same. Yesterday, today, and forever. And there he makes the announcement and the proclamation. And he tells you tonight that you can rest assured. He will save your soul. He will heal your sicknesses. He will destroy the works of the devil in your life. He will set you free. Because the power to do that resides in him. All power in heaven and on earth has been given unto him. And therefore tonight, manifestation will come in your life. Tonight I want to examine that verse of scripture with you. The conquering power of the risen Christ. The conquering power of the risen Christ. Look at that verse again. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, and that Jesus Christ, the same Jesus, comes tonight. He has not changed his message. He has not changed his ministry. Manifestation always comes and follows after him. And when you believe that name, when you rest in that name, when you receive the blessing of that name, the might and the power, the manifestation, his ministry, will come upon your life as he announces to you tonight, all power without limitation, all power without restriction, all power without any hindrance, all power is given unto him in heaven and in earth. That's why it says, go ye therefore and teach all nations. Three things I'm talking about before we pray. Number one, the majestic power of the risen Christ. I want you to come back to Matthew chapter 28. And once again, remember the words of Jesus. Once again, inject your mind with the words of Jesus. Inject your life with the words of Jesus. Because he comes and he says, all power. Majestic power. The power of the king. Royal power. Divine power. Heavenly power. All power is given unto me. And he says in heaven. Maybe your problem is coming from the sky. Maybe it's coming from your stars. Maybe it's coming from the clouds. Maybe it's coming from on high. There's a higher power that is greater than that power tormenting your life. The majestic power of Jesus Christ. The royal power of Jesus Christ. The kingly power of Jesus Christ. Power irresistible. Power unlimited. Power unrestrained. Coming from the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. The majestic power of our risen Christ. I want to read something to you in Psalm 2. Psalm 2, I'm reading from verse 6. And there you will see his royalty. You will see his kingship. You see that Jesus Christ is anointed, ordained as a king. And because he's a king, he has power. And he comes with that power of the king in your life tonight. Thank God your problems are solved. Thank God forgiveness is coming to you. Thank God the salvation is coming to you. Psalm 2, I'm reading from verse 6. Here is the Almighty God talking. Here's a creator God in heaven talking. And he's talking about Jesus Christ, his only begotten son. In Psalm 2 verse 6. He says, yet have I set my king upon my holy mount of Zion. Is that talking about David? I said, is that talking about David? No, go ahead and you will see it's not talking of David. Look at verse 7. I will declare the decree. The Lord has said unto me, thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. And you see a capital S there. Ask of me, verse 8, and I shall give thee the heathen for thine inheritance, and the uttermost parts of the earth for thy possession. And then he goes on to tell us what you are to do with that son of God. Here is the King of Kings. Here is the Lord of Lords. Here is the King in his majesty. Here is the regal one. Here is the one that has royal authority. Here is the King Jesus. Here is the King Savior. Here is the King Redeemer. Here is the King that can forgive your sin. And the Almighty God said, I set him up. I anointed him. I placed him there for your good, for your redemption, for your salvation, that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord tonight shall be saved. Tonight you call on the name of the Lord, you are going to be saved. Because the Almighty God said, that's the one I have anointed and appointed. He says, there are no two people on that seat. That seat of authority. That seat of power. That seat everlasting, eternal. Is my King. I set him up there. And he says, ask of me. Telling the Lord Jesus Christ. He says, all the heathen in the world. All the people of the world. He said, I'll keep them unto you. And actually the Father has given you unto him. It's now for you to surrender unto him and say, he is my King, he is my Lord, he is my Savior, he is my Redeemer. He rose in power. The stone was rolled away. The guards of earthly authority fell on the ground. They were helpless. He won permanent victory over man's many enemies. Christ now has power over your sin, over your darkness, over your curse, over the eternal judgment that shall come upon your life. He has power over Satan, has power over your sickness, has power over the demons that are tormenting your life. And the moment you surrender to him, the moment you give yourself to him, the moment you say, he will be my Savior, my Lord, he will be my King, he will be captain of my salvation, I surrender, I give myself to him, I totally give my heart, my soul, everything to the Lord. Remember, he has authority now to forgive your sin. He has authority to take all the condemnation away. He has authority from heaven to take all the guilt away. And then to give you a new life. And it's coming today. I said it's coming today. Anybody there, I said it's coming today. Anybody waiting there, I said it's coming today. The power of his word. It will speak to you, your sins will go away. It will speak to you, your sicknesses will go away. It will speak to you, immediately all those demons will vanish away. Yes, majestic power.
Oni agbara ola nla.
That's why I rose from the dead.
Nitori eyi lo si ji
de fo. That's why I come to you today.
De lo si to wa lale.
And it says I have power in heaven and on earth.
Mo ni agbara ni orun ati le aye.
In Ecclesiastes chapter 8 verse 4.
Oni waasu ori kani ese ori ka jo ese kani.
Ecclesiastes chapter 8 verse 4.
Oni waasu ori ka jo ese kani.
It says where the word of a king is, there is power.
Nibiti oro ba gbe wa agbara nbe nibe.
What if I need to Jesus Christ now?
To wa ri Jesus bayi.
That's why when he was here on earth,
de to si wa na aye.
Everywhere he went, there was manifestation.
Ibi kibi to ba lo ifarahan
ba wa. Because he's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Ori gbe oni oba awon oba Oluwa
Oluwa. His word is the word of the king.
Oro re oro ba ni.
His power is the power of the king.
Agbara.
His authority is the authority of a king. And he was not just a ruling over people alone, over their problems as well. When he saw a blind man and said, "Your eyes be opened," that was the final word.
And
the eyes became well, open. When he saw the lame and he said, "Rise up and walk," that was the final word. If the demons have been operating anywhere, those demons don't have a final word. When Jesus comes, the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings, and he says, "Come out," they come out immediately. Because where the word of the king is, there is power. He's going to speak to your problem tonight. He's going to speak to your sin tonight. When he says your sins are forgiven, final. When he says you are saved, final. When he says you are brought into the kingdom of God, that's final. And when he tells that spirit of insanity in your brain there, come out, that's final. When he tells that cancer there, dry up, that's final. Any sickness in your body, any disease there, he says, be healed, that's final. That's the kind of power Jesus manifests. And thank God tonight is coming to you. I say thank God tonight is coming to you. If you believe that, say amen. Number one, there's majestic power. Number two, there is mighty power. I'm talking about mountain moving power. I'm talking about a kind of bulldozer power that will level every mountain of your life. I'm talking about dynamite. Explosive power that will blow up everything that has been walking about in your life. It will level every valley. It will remove every hill. Because he has the power. Number one, it's majestic. Number two, it is mighty. The mighty power of our reigning conqueror. He has conquered. And when he comes to your life, you too, you will conquer in Jesus' name. Your conquering will start from tonight. I will conquer. Somebody there, I will conquer. This sin will not conquer me, I will conquer. Are you there? This temptation will not conquer me, I will conquer. I want heaven to hear your voice. This temptation will not conquer me. This trial will not conquer me. This power of darkness will not conquer me. This evil spirit will not conquer my family. This sickness will not kill me. Let heaven hear your voice. This sickness will not kill me. I will conquer. I said I will conquer. I said I will conquer. When the mighty power of conquering Christ comes to you, the reigning Christ that comes to you, when you believe that, you accept that, when you hold on to that, you say, I will not let it go. Power coming from Calvary. Power coming from Christ. Power coming from the reigning Christ comes upon every area of my life. It will work in your life. That's why there's going to be manifestation. Manifestation. It will happen in Jesus' name. You remember the verse we're looking at in chapter 28 of Matthew. And in verse 18, and Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. All power is given unto me in heaven and on earth. Look up here for a moment. There are some people that claim to have power. Why in any particular locality? Maybe they go by the riverside. They say, I have power. If you transfer them out of that riverside and you transfer them to dry land, they don't have power anymore. Some people claim to have power on the mountain. If they go to the mountain, then they begin to act as if there's something there. Remove them and bring them to the valley. They come ordinary and there's no power. Some people may stay somewhere in a particular shade, and then they claim to have power. Get them out of that shed and put them somewhere else. They don't have power anymore. Here is Jesus Christ in the valley on the mountain, but the river in the desert, in heaven and here on earth, over there overseas or here in our land, here where I'm standing and there where you're sitting. All power in heaven, all power on earth have been given unto him. And when he speaks your life tonight, power manifestation will come unto you in Jesus' name. Some people, they have power on a special day. And if you go to them on that day, after they have gone here, they have gone there, they have done this, they have done that, and they look at, they say, this is the day. Then they begin to manifest something that looks like power. Let that day pass. It looks like now they are ordinary like everybody else. But Jesus Christ has power every day. Whether it is Sunday or Saturday, it is Wednesday or Friday, or Monday or Thursday, or Tuesday or any other day, power belongs to Christ. He reigns supreme. He reigns without a rival. Any day, any year, any month, any time. And today for you. I said today for you. I said today for you. He has power. All power is given unto him, both in heaven and on earth. Some people claim to have power power. If they can have some bottle of oil, give me oil, power will come. Other people seem to have power. When they can get some bottle of water, special water from River Jordan, then they say there is power. Other people claim to have power. When they can burn something like incense, they say there is power. But Jesus doesn't need anything like that. And today, speak the word only, and my servant shall be healed. And that word of power is coming unto you. No bottle of water, we're talking about Jesus. No bottle of oil, we're talking about Jesus. No candle and no incense, we're talking about Jesus. Some people claim to have power when they can be in a particular posture. If they can lie down, if they can kneel down, if they can put their head on the ground, if they can do some gymnastics, then they say there's power, because the power comes from the sweat. But Jesus Christ is just says calmly, and he says, blind eyes be opened, and your eyes are opened. It's a power that came from heaven, and that power is coming to you tonight, because Jesus Christ said, where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am in the midst of them. Jesus is there. Do you know that? Where you are there, Jesus is there. The one who will forgive your sin, Jesus is there. The one who will redeem your life, Jesus is there. The one who will break every yoke in your life, Jesus is there. And Jesus came unto them saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and on earth. And that power is here to bring a manifestation in your life. It will do it in Jesus' name. He reigns on earth. He reigns in heaven. He reigns as conqueror. He reigns as creator. He reigns on high. He reigns here below. He reigns everywhere. He's going to reign in your life. He will reign in your heart. He will reign all through eternity. He reigns to conquer that stranger in your life. He will conquer that sin in your life. He will conquer that demon in your life. He will conquer that sickness in your life. He will cast out that evil spirit in your life. Every spirit of torment, he will drive out of your life tonight. Because he reigns. Because he reigns. Because he reigns. And nothing can stop that power of his. You come and you give your soul to the Lord. You give your life to the Lord. What you could not do by yourself, you have been making resolutions. I will not say that anymore. I will not do that anymore. I will not go there anymore. I will not act like that anymore. But you could not do that. Resolution could not help you. But Jesus has the power to change your life and turn your life around. He will take that bad character away. He'll make you a nice and a good person. The grace of God will come to your life. And what you need have power to do before, the strength to live righteously, that strength will come to your life tonight. I rejoice with you because of that power that will be manifested in your life tonight. Do you know it will heal your sickness? I said, do you know it will heal your sickness? Do you know it will cure you of every disease? Do you know it will set you free? Say amen. Say, I believe. Say, I accept. Say, I'm going to see manifestation tonight.
Hey,
let me show you the summary of the ministry of Christ. To show you what kind of power he has. What kind of authority he has. It's in Acts chapter 10, verse 38. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power. Do you notice there the Holy Trinity? God the Almighty, God the Creator, anointed Jesus Christ the Son with the Holy Ghost and the power, who went about doing good. He has not changed. He goes about doing good. It's the same here tonight. He goes about doing good. He's going to do that in your life. He goes about doing good. And healing all that were oppressed of the devil. Healing all that were oppressed of the devil. Those on the left hand side, they are healing all that were oppressed of the devil. Those at the center, the front over there, healing all that were oppressed of the devil. Those on the right hand side, healing all that were oppressed of the devil. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. For God was with him. And God says, I am God, I change not. And Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And what he did before, he's still doing today. And he's going to do it in your life tonight in Jesus' name. He will forgive your sins. He will give you peace of mind. He will give you salvation. He will redeem your soul. He will write your name in the book of life in heaven. They will give you new life, everlasting life, eternal life. You will never be the same again. Number one is the majestic power. Number two is the mighty power. Number three is the manifold power. Many sided power. You come to this side, you meet power. You meet him on this side, you meet power. You meet him in another angle, you have power. Every side of Jesus is many sided power. Anywhere you are, you call upon him, and you have power there. The cross of Jesus Christ is at the center. And all the sides of the cross of Christ, you are in the east, you are in the west, you are in the north, you are in the south, you are in any direction, and you look up to Jesus Christ who died for you. If there is no part of him that does not ooze out and beam out and shine out and send out and drive out the power. There's no part of him that doesn't have power. And anywhere you are, any direction where you are, here Jesus comes to announce to you. And he says, and Jesus came unto them. As you're expecting him, your expectation will be fulfilled in Jesus' name. You will not come here as a spectator. You will not be an onlooker. But you are going to come to the side of Christ. And the power of Christ, manifold, many-sided, whatever the need may be. You need salvation, there's that side, he's our Savior. You need healing, it's on that side, it's our healer. You need deliverance, it's from that side, it's deliverer. You need provision, it's from that side, it's provider. You need renewal, it's from that side, it's the power of resurrection. You need a change in your life. It's the one that comes to transform our lives. The many-sided and the manifold power of a redeeming captive. All he wants you to do is to talk to him. And to forsake your sin. And to accept that you are a sinner. Just like you accept, you are a black man. You are a Yoruba man. You are an Igbo man. You are somebody from this other side. There's nothing derogatory about that. That's who you are. You are a man, you are a woman. So when you say, I'm a man, that's right. You say, I'm a woman, that's right. When you say, I'm a sinner, that's right. Because all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And the only Savior the Father has given to us is the one that died for us on the cross of Calvary. And you come to him confessing. And you say, you are my Savior. You are my Lord. And then you give your heart unto the Lord. And say, I'll not go back to those evil things anymore. Jesus, my Savior. Sin out. Evil things out. Darkness out. All those wickedness in your life, everything comes out. And you say, Jesus will be my Savior. When you say, I'm a sinner, you're my Savior. That's right. When you say, I am sick, you're my healer. That's right. That's right. And he's your healer. Because he will drive that sickness away. I am in captivity, I'm oppressed, and you're my deliverer. We have the manifold power of a redeeming captive. He'll break the chains in your life. He'll destroy the evil in your life. He will set you free. Somebody there said they will set you free. I said they will set you free. And tonight is that night. Somebody there said tonight is that night. Manifold power. Many-sided power. Mighty power. Majestic power. Power in manifestation. Power in signs and wonders. Power in salvation. Power in healing. Power in deliverance. Is there tonight by your side? Where are you there? I said, where are you there? Power coming upon your life. Power coming upon your life. Tonight. I said tonight. When is your salvation? I said tonight. When is your forgiveness? I said tonight. When is your healing? I said tonight. When is your deliverance? I said tonight. Now he comes to you. And he says, look to him. Look to him. All power in heaven and on earth is given unto him. Believe it will happen in your life. Are you ready? I said, believe and manifestation will come in your life. I said, are you ready? I said, are you ready? Heads bowed and eyes closed. I'm calling you now to a point of decision. Because this is manifestation time. Manifestation of forgiveness. Manifestation of redemption. Manifestation of peace of mind. Manifestation of entry to the kingdom of God. Manifestation of eternal life. It's bowed and eyes closed. You want to surrender your life to Jesus Christ so that his power can flow into your life. His forgiveness can flow into your life. His salvation can flow into your life. You are there tonight. You are making up your mind. Wherever you are, right, center, back, in front, or the left, you say, Christ will be my savior from tonight. Raise up that hand. Wonderful. Raise up that hand. Wonderful. Raise up that hand there. Wonderful. You're making up your mind. You're taking a decision. I come out of darkness. I come into the light. I come out of my sin. I come to the Savior. I come out of wickedness. I come to the goodness of the Lord. I come out of the dungeon. I come to his redemption. Wherever you are, you raise up your hand. If you're raising up your hand, you will stand up. You will stand up. You say, I stand up out of the crowd. I will not be lost in the crowd. Jesus, I am here. Jesus, I am here. You will be my Savior. Jesus, I am here. Where are you? Jesus, I am here. Raise up that hand and stand up. You will be my Savior. You will take my sins away. You'll take my guilt away. You'll take my condemnation away. Jesus, have mercy on me. I believe you died for me on the cross of Calvary. Raise up that hand and stand up. Rise up and tell the Lord. Open your mouth and tell the Lord there, I surrender my life unto you. I give my life unto you. I will not go back to any other sin anymore. You are the final authority in my life, the final power in my life, my Savior and my Lord. And he's going to write your name in the book of life in heaven. And then when the time comes, he'll take you to heaven. Keep on standing. We're going to pray together. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for this moment of manifestation. Manifestation of your love. Manifestation of forgiveness. Manifestation of grace. Manifestation of mercy. Manifestation of salvation. I pray for all your people who are standing and those who have made up their minds and they surrender their lives to Christ as the Lord and Savior. Forgive them in Jesus' name. Forgive them in Jesus' name. Take their sins away. Take the condemnation away. Take the guilt away. Write their names in the book of life in heaven. Let them enter now into the kingdom of God. Lord, I pray the joy of salvation will come to them, and the peace in salvation will come to them, and the power to go and live a new life grant unto them now in Jesus' name. We thank you because when we call upon you, you always answer. Whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Thank you for that salvation. Confirm it in every life, Lord. We thank you because we know you have done it. In Jesus' name we pray. A loud amen. You're waiting for the miracle. Praise the Lord. You know manifestation is coming upon your life now. Praise the Lord. As we pray tonight, there will be a manifestation in your life. Any infirmity, any sickness, any disease you have, the Lord will take everything away. Remember, all power belongs to him, Christ. And that power will heal your sickness. And so whatever problem you have, identify that problem. Just lay your hand on the problem. You're lame. You are blind. Deaf and dumb. You have swollen your body. You have evil spirit tormenting your life. Whatever it is, as we pray, and we pray in this mighty name of Jesus, when you hear the final amen, it means it is done. Then you check up yourself, you'll discover your miracle there. So lay your hand where you have the problem, raise up the other hand. Get ready, it's coming. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you because we know you are still mighty. Your power has not changed, and your love has not changed. Grace and mercy, you have not changed. And therefore, Lord, I pray that your power will flow into every life now, in Jesus' name. Every power of darkness tormenting anyone, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Spirit of insanity, madness, come out in Jesus' name. Those spirits walking about in the body, tormenting the life, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have any swelling in their body. Whatever the swelling may be. In the head, in the neck, in the armpit, anywhere. Lord, I pray that swelling come out in Jesus' name. That mountain of a problem be removed in Jesus' name. And every plant the heavenly Father has not planted in your body, it's uprooted now in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who have any other internal sickness, internal infirmity, causing pain in their body, affliction in their body, I send for the power of God upon your body right now. Be healed in Jesus' name. I pray for those who are deaf and dumb. Touch their deaf ears. Touch their dumb tongues. Deaf ears, begin to hear in Jesus' name. Dumb tongues, speak out in Jesus' name. I pray for those who are blind. I command that bandage of the devil to be removed from your eyesight. Cataract, come out in Jesus' name. Glaucoma, come out in Jesus' name. Dimness of sight, be healed in Jesus' name. I pray for those who are lame, those who are paralyzed, those who have stroke, those who have that sense of broken bones. Lord, touch them, raise them up in Jesus' name. Broken bones, come together, be mended right now, be healed in Jesus' name. Withered hand, stretch it out and be whole in Jesus' name. Short leg, grow out now in Jesus' name. Stroke, be healed in Jesus' name. Lame man, rise up and walk in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray that everywhere now there will be manifestation. To the left, to the right, manifestation. At the back, in the front, manifestation. Miracle everywhere. Healing everywhere. Deliverance everywhere. Receive your miracle. Thank you because we know you have answered. Confirm the miracle. miracle in every life. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Final, 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 amen. Praise the Lord, it's done. I said, praise the Lord, it's done. Check up yourself, check up yourself. You'll find your miracle is there.
Praise the Lord. My name is Mosumola Ola Belu. I'm from Moro. I came here feeling stone on my two breasts. My friends actually told me that it's something like cancer, but I never went to the hospital because I believe in God. And when I came here today, they told us to hold where it's paining us. Then I held my breast, and glory be to God. I can't feel anything like stone on my chest. Thank God.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Lord has done it. Your healing shall be permanent.
Iwo sayin yo si bayin kale. Ola belo loruko arabirin wa Mosumola. Won ni ka won to wa bi nkan kan dun won ni aya to dabi okuta ti won pe ni oruko bi jejere. Sugba nigba ti ranse Olorun gbadura ani kini to dun won yen si pora. Gbogbo n ton dun won yen ala nfo kan ko dun won mo Olorun ti mu okuta ibe kuro. Eke hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Mo dupe lowo Olorun. Mo wa lati ilu mi abi ti mo gbe.
Your address.
Mo wa lati more ni Ijeoma Maria Olateju loruko mi. Mo wa lati Ijeoma re ile ife nbi. Igba ta n bo lowo osan bi ro leyen. Orun attack ni o ti to bi osun kan to tin ro mi. Mo lo sodo aposkudi nbi bayi woli ni mo ni momo mo ni orun ati owo yi nro mi fun mi ni eto kin ti e fi ra mo fi ororo ra nile na ko se be tin bi ta tin gbadura mo sa ri pe riro yen ko ro mi mo so mo dupe lowo olorun ko olorun tun gbadura fun mi siwaju ko ma tun ijo mi den
ko ni wa mo loruko Jesu
amen
e ti gbawo san yin o.
You have been healed. Praise the Lord. Her name is Maria Olateju from Ijeomore. Before she came here, she had terrible pain in her neck, on her chest, and even at her back. And she had been to many places, to prophetess and many places. But by when she came here tonight, the man of God prayed, and could you believe it? The pain all over her neck, all over her body disappeared miraculously. And now God has healed her instantaneously. Praise the Lord.
Don't see check up if you are there, expecting miracle. The next person.
Praise the Lord. My name is Fomakama Abosedi. I'm from Mokwa Group of District. Before I came here, I was having neck pain. But when the pastor prayed, I was not having any pain again. Yes.
Amen.
Ki won to wa orun dun won fa ma kin wa bose loruko won sugbon leyin adura an ni irora yen pora ni ko si ni pada sibe mo loruko Jesu.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is good. Actually, I'm not a member of this deeper life. My name is Ifaka Ufuma. I'm from Modaike. Somebody invited me to this program, but before I came to this program, I had a dream that a prayer session was going on and I started vomiting. And before I came here, I was diagnosed that I had to undergo an operation. If you can look to my neck region, you see a ball. So when the man of God was saying, there are some people here that something is swollen on your body, your neck, whatever. I just had the strong feeling that it is me the man of God was talking to. And immediately I placed my hand on that spot. It's here. And I placed my hand on it and I told God that the revelation I saw that I started vomiting, everything that is not planted in my body, I will vomit it in the name of Jesus. And I tap into the prayer point, and immediately the man of God was praying. I started vomiting. I said, God, I thank you because your word has come. And indeed, my healing will come. And I tapped my faith. I started vomiting immediately. Normally, when I swallow saliva, there's this pain on my chest. But immediately the man of God said, just continue to do those things you couldn't do. And I started swallowing the saliva. I even took water and swallowed. It was just going freely. It was just going freely. I just want to thank God. Because he's the King of Kings. Indeed, he has perfected his healing. I will never undergo that operation in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus.
Abiri wa ni ifaka ifuoma won ka to wa bi won ni kankan wu si won lorun nigba ti ranse olorun gbadura lekan won ni bi ki bi ti kankan ba wu si o lara pe ko gbo wole be won la won ba gbo wole orun won ni bi ti kan yen wu si won la fi ti kan yen dede pora awon ba bere si gbe to mi pe abi be ni abi eko won ni afi ti to bere si lo gerege awon ba tun mu omi lomi na bere si lo gerege awon wa ke si pe n to ti wu o ti pora danu.
The next testifier, please.
Praise the Lord. My name is Isaac.
Speak louder, please.
Isaac Mawalati Ile Ife Arubid. Problem Timoni Aramon Yumi. So come on about best in your mini lesson. But Mbati Ojisalon Badra. After I got badra mokon requeo to come more mini.
Hallelujah.
God healed our brother Isaac from serious rheumatism. And by the grace of God, after the prayer of the man of God, that miracle happened in his life. And now he's being healed.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I'm Owolabi Bukola from DLCF OAU. I want to bless God for what he did for me tonight. So from then to now, I've been having some sensation in my throat. I don't know whether it's sore throat or whatever. But sometimes it's difficult to breathe. But I want to thank God because tonight God healed me. And I also want to thank God because for some time also I've been having involuntary knee flexion. That whenever I'm walking, I just kneel down greeting people without control. But I want to thank God because tonight God has perfected my healing. Praise God.
Olorun wo arabirin wa owo labi buko lasan. Won ni egbo lo fun won, won le gbe to mi won le mu nkan. Sugba tel ni sin leyin adura, won Olorun ti wo won san. Gbogbo egbo ati to ndu won lo fun yen o ti pora.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
My name is Oriofela Nipekun. Actually, I'm from Deeper Life Campus Fellowship. I have this pain in my teeth for over a year now. This pain do come, most especially in this kind of weather, in this cold weather. It's just so serious that, in fact, I'm almost, it's not because of God. I could have even died from that pain. But today, when the JS prayed, he said we should lay our hand on those things. Well, we are feeling pain. I laid my hand on it, and to the glory of God, I am healed. I tested it. Normally, if I drink cold water or any water, I will feel this pain. But I drank water, and I didn't feel any pain. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.